Markle and Prince Harry have touched down in Morocco for their four-day visit to the country. The couple were treated to an impressive guard of honor as they stepped off the plane onto a red carpet at Casablanca Airport this evening, an hour later than planned after a last-minute hitch. The pregnant Duchess, 37, looked stunning in a red Valentino cape dress, a color which has considerable historic significance in the country, and represents hardiness, bravery, strength and valor on the national flag. She teamed the bespoke dress with nude heels, gloves and a clutch bag. While Harry, 34, looked dapper in a gray suit. The couple, who will welcome their first child in the next few weeks, are due to spend time in Casablanca, a SNE and rabbit visiting organizations that champion causes close to their hearts. They are also set to meet the Moroccan royal family. The pair were greeted at the airport by the British ambassador to Morocco Thomas Riley and his wife Alex. The royal couple were then set to meet the 15-year-old Crown Prince, Moulay Hassan, dubbed one of the richest teenagers in the world. The Duke and Duchess are fitting in 7 engagements over the next few days. A doctor is not traveling with Meghan, but a palace spokesperson said medical provisions have been made, thought to be the Moroccan king's personal physician. Aides also confirmed the parents dubia are traveling with an entourage of 9 palace staff. Tomorrow they will head to a school boarding house run by Education for All, an organization for girls in rural areas of the country. They will have the chance to meet some of the teens who live there, and Meghan will take part in a henna ceremony, before heading to a nearby secondary school to watch children play football. In the evening they will attend a formal reception hosted by the British ambassador Mr. Riley in Rabat, where they will meet influential women, young entrepreneurs and disabled athletes. On Monday, Harry and Meghan are due to meet the King of Morocco, who has for the last 2 years been embroiled in controversy over his rumored divorce from his wife Princess Lala Salma, the first for a Moroccan king. The princess had not been seen in public since 2017, and is now rumored to be living in exile in the United States. Moroccan officials are hoping not to have a repeat of the Queen's first and last tour of the country in 1983, dubbed the Tour from Hell after a series of diplomatic disasters. It looks as if our prediction earlier in the month could be coming true. Meghan, the Duchess of Sussex, has threatened the Mail on Sunday with legal action under the Copyright, Designs and Patents Act for publishing a private letter she sent to her father, in which she said he had broken her heart into a million pieces. Representatives of the Duchess, formerly known as Meghan Markle, have been in touch with the newspaper after its decision earlier this month to publish the handwritten message sent to Thomas Markle, in which, according to sources, she complained with a heavy heart about the pain her father was causing by giving media interviews. Meghan complained to her father about manufacturing this fictitious narrative about being cut out of her life with Prince Harry, aided by his regular newspaper and TV interviews. Thomas Markle missed last year's royal wedding after it was revealed he had colluded with the paparazzi agency to stage photos of himself at home in Mexico. He allowed the Mail on Sunday to publish extracts of the letter earlier this month, saying he was doing so in response to critical interviews given by the Duchess's friends in the US magazine People. The newspaper commissioned a handwriting expert to analyze the letter. Royals have previously invoked the Copyright Act in an attempt to keep material out of the public domain. The Mail on Sunday was targeted by Prince Charles in 2005 after it published extracts from a journal he wrote for friends during the handover of Hong Kong to China. The Daily Telegraph has previously suggested that Kensington Palace was considering a similar approach over the recent letter penned by the Duchess's father. It is unclear how the Mail on Sunday will respond to the potential legal action, and the letter remains available on Mail Online. A letter is a copyright work as it is a literary work, said Alex Newman, the national head of intellectual property law at Solicitors Irwin Mitchell. As soon as you create a copyright work, you will own the copyright until it expires automatically. This gives you the right to prevent anyone else copying or issuing to the public the whole or a substantial part of your copyrighted work. The Mail on Sunday printed 9 separate extracts from the 5-page handwritten letter, which were promoted on the front page as a world exclusive. Newman said there were exceptions from copyright law for fair dealing when reporting current events and reviews, meaning it was possible to publish extracts without the approval of the creator in certain circumstances. He said the newspaper's legal justification for publishing could rest on whether it published a substantial part of the letter, taking into account both the proportion of the letter that was printed and the importance of the sections that were used. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry safety fears as royal couple fly into Morocco city rocked by violence days before visit. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are said to have been banned from walkabouts over safety fears after riots in Morocco. Riots in Morocco's capital Rabat have sparked security fears ahead of a visit by Prince Harry and Meghan. The Duchess of Sussex, who is 7 months pregnant, is due to fly in on Saturday with Prince Harry for a 3-day tour. But fears for the safety of the royal couple have been raised after riots broke out during a march by teachers demanding more pay. Protester Naima Kalei said, "The police are cracking down on us. Teachers are falling to the ground. Teachers are being insulted." Police also used water cannon to disperse the crowds. Royal protection officers are said to be worried about the situation and have banned the royal couple from walkabouts. British security services have also demanded more resources to protect the pair, according to the Mirror. It is thought exit plans have been drawn up to ferry them out of harm's way or even out of the country, should trouble flare up once again. A source told the paper, the decision was taken to not include a walkabout in Morocco over fears for the Duke and Duchess's safety. Both Meghan and Harry draw huge crowds wherever they go in the world, and they have a real propensity to get in among the crowds, interacting with them very closely. Due to the nature of the protests across the country, this was strongly advised against, which they both understood. Reports from the country suggest protests have been peaceful, but police reaction has been heavy-handed, which has thrown up obvious concerns that tensions could flare up if repeated during the royal visit. Those responsible with protecting the royals on foreign visits have sought strong assurances security will be bolstered during the couple's trip. MI6 also requested an intelligence report from Moroccan authorities after the riots, according to the Mirror. As part of their trip, Harry and Meghan are due to visit the town of Asni, close to the Atlas Mountains, to visit a project called Education for All. They are also due to spend Monday in Rabat visiting an equestrian center, attending a cookery demonstration and touring the Andalusian Gardens. Meghan Markle has donated flowers from her baby shower to charity. Earlier this week, the Duchess of Sussex flew to New York City for a baby shower with attendees including friends Amal Clooney and Serena Williams. Following the shower, Repeat Roses, an organization which recycles flowers from events and sends them to hospitals and care centers, revealed it had been gifted flowers from Meghan, who is due to give birth in April. The recycled flowers were gifted to pediatric cancer patients at Ronald McDonald House Charities of New York, cancer patients at Hope Lodge, and individuals receiving care at Unique People Services. Repeat Roses was so honored to help pedal it forward with a baby shower experience for the Duchess of Sussex and her thoughtful friends by creating a ripple effect of kindness across the community, Repeat Roses CEO Jennifer Grove told People. CBS News Morning Show co-host Gail King, who attended the baby shower, revealed Meghan's plans to donate the flowers on Thursday. "I've never seen anything like this at a baby shower," said King on CBS This Morning. "They did flower decorations. They brought in somebody to explain how to arrange flowers." King said that the guests at the shower each made a floral arrangement in a vase for Meghan to donate to Repeat Roses. "It just speaks to who she is. She's very kind, very generous," she added. The donation comes almost a year after Meghan and the Duke of Sussex donated their wedding flowers to a hospice in London. An archway of flowers, designed by florist Philippa Craddock, adorned St. George's Chapel in Windsor Castle at the couple's wedding on the 19th of May 2018. Following the wedding, the flowers were sent to various hospices and women's refuges, including St. Joseph's Hospice in Hackney. The healthcare facility thanked the newlyweds for the very special delivery on Facebook, alongside a photo of a patient posing with a bouquet. "Today we got a very special delivery. Beautiful bouquets made from the hashtag Royal Wedding Flowers which we gave to our patients," read the post on Facebook. A big thank you to Harry and Meghan and florist Philippa Craddock. "Our hospice smells and looks gorgeous. Such a lovely gesture."